First of all, there was a betrothal. The Father has arranged this wedding. According to Ephesians 1 and verse 4, He chose you and me. He chose us in Him before the foundation of the world. Think about it, that He chose you in Him before He even created Adam and Eve. He chose you. So it's an arranged wedding. Jesus initiated the betrothal marriage contract with the new covenant. So do you remember the betrothal? They would have the marriage contract and they would go under the canopy and they would drink the cup of wine. Then Jesus, this is the night He was betrayed before He was crucified, He took the cup, He gave thanks and offered it to them saying, "Drink from it, all of you. This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I will not drink of this fruit of the vine from now on until the day when I drink it anew with you in my Father's kingdom." The bridal payment, the payment was made, and it wasn't with sheep, it wasn't with silver or gold, but you and I, the Bible tells us, have been bought at a price with the precious blood of Jesus, that we've been purchased. They sang a new song. "You are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals because you were slain." Come on, church. "And with your blood, you purchased men for God from every tribe, language, people, and nation." In the Jewish wedding, the groom would leave his bride a gift so that she would remember him. It was a guarantee, "I'm coming back." So the groom would give his bride a gift as collateral, saying, "This is for you to remember that I'm going to prepare a place, but I'm coming back. And in the meantime, this is the guarantee that I will be back." What gift did Jesus give us as an earnest deposit, collateral guarantee that He's coming back? And it was the gift of the Holy Spirit. We are now in a season of preparation. The biggest thing, I hope that you guys catch what I'm about to say. The big thing is that wedding dress. And the girls are working out, and they're not eating any Twinkies, and they're taking care of themselves, and they're probably constantly doing this. And in addition to that, it's the dress, it's keeping yourself fit, taking care of yourself, and it's the makeup and the hair to make yourself as beautiful as possible to present yourself to the groom. That we don't let ourselves get spiritually flabby and out of shape. Come on, that we stay with the disciplines. Are you hearing me? Of prayer, reading the scriptures, getting in church, come on, sharing your faith. Because we want to, with every day, make ourselves ready.